today we're going to be doing the ACF50 on the Fazer. So the hardest part is the prep, really, covering the wheels, covering the bits that you touch. I've used cling film because it binds to it easily and it leaves the mechanics free, but I do want to rust prevent, because for some reason on this bike it's getting rusty really easy. So obviously this is the ACF50. It's been soaking in warm water. It's a bit cold today, so that's going to go on now. I'm going to cover the whole bike. I've covered the wheels, so the brakes, but there is some parts of the brakes that I want to do, because some of the nuts and mechanisms do get rusty. But I'll apply that by hand, which will work fine. So I'm just going to cover the whole bike. I'm sure you've seen this before, just showing you how I do it. I'll be doing one as well with the compressor soon. I'll be doing the bandit with that. So we've got cling film on the bits you touch and on the pedals. We're not going to get on the wheels, but to be honest, when I've done anything with a bike, whether it's chain lubing, cleaning, anything using oils, then I'll clean the wheels anyway, the tyres especially, should I say, just in case there's anything on there that's slipped through. So let's get on with this. Just a nice even spray. Go under the tank. That's why I want to use a compressor, really, because the compressor makes a nice fine mist. Mistles and Flyer did a really good video using this compressor, and that's kind of inspired me to use mine. I mean, there's loads of videos out there on this particular subject, so this is there's nothing really different about this video. I think the only difference is I've used cling film on a lot of bits. It's a nice fine mist. As you can see, I've put a sheet down to prevent doing it everywhere on the floor and then slipping when we go out. Got the fork sanctions. Safe on electronics, which is awesome. I'm not going to get on the clocks though, or the mirrors. It's a bitch to get off the mirrors. The spray bottle's quite good actually. Better than the aerosol apparently. Again, a million videos out there about that. I will be doing the chain as well. I've cleaned the chain, took the worst off it. This is fine on chains, and the thing is, you put it on a chain, let it settle in, and then I'll lube the chain, and I'm hoping it stops the chain getting rusty, because for some reason on this bike it keeps getting rusty, even though I'm using multiple chain lube and I've used it for a few others. Once that's run out, I'm going to start using gear oil as recommended by the manufacturer. No idea why I did it anyway, but you sort of get sucked into this using the certain lubes and that. But yeah, let's carry on. Covering every inch of the bike. Might have to
just realising I can't move the tyre. But just please don't move the tyre as well. Okay, so I fluffed on that a little bit. Where I'm winging it. So once that's settled in, I'll do a chain separate. It's worth noting that I've used that much of the bowl to do that so far. I'm just going to put a bit more in. And if I was in a compressor, the Mr. Ply uses less than egg cup, which is fantastic. So what I'll do now is just leave it to dry, seep in for half an hour, let it find its way and do its thing. And then we'll come out and dry it off, and that should be about done, apart from just touching up some of the bits you can't spray on. Clean the wheels, job done. So now we've left it half an hour, so I'm going to give it a wipe down and rub it all in into the bottom places and sort of dry it off as such. And then clean the wheels, and then we're about done. I mean, using that spray bottle, it does seem to put quite a lot on. So it'll be interesting to see when I use the compressor how easy it is to sort of clean off. I mean, this is not too bad, because it doesn't matter if there's a bit in there. And when you first start the bike up, it's going to smoke quite a bit just to burn off the excess on the exhaust and the hot bits. So don't be too alarmed. If you've watched any videos, you've heard that already. And that's it really, just keep going. Moving it in, does make the plastics and rubber look absolutely brand new. No wonder Valentine's use it. Just take it off camera and give you a close look just at the little tiny bit I've done. So it just looks brighter such side of the camera, so you can see. So it looks quite shiny. It's a great job. So it's all wiped down and dry. I'm just doing using the camera's mic, someone's banging away in the background. But as you can see, the blacks just come up beautiful. Really nice, maybe a bit brighter, really nice. The ACF50 didn't have to leave a nice shine. And in there just looks like brand new. Really happy with the ACF50 to be honest. XCP obviously gives it a run for its money, but it's very sticky and leaves horrible residue. So I think this just does the job nice.